first time out for that driver, Alan Smith, and he figured out how to run good for half a lap, and then it all came unglued in turn three, got crossed up, and then that 88's been through a lot this year. That might be the end of it.
Now, hard lick there in turns three and four. The 88 car just in the hard road out of Deltona, Florida. They're checking on him down there. The 87 car right out in front of everybody got wicked sideways, and instead of it just spinning down to the inside, it grabbed a handful of wheel and it shot right up the racetrack and right into the path of the 88H. Heavy front contact, not only with the car, but then the impact on the outside wall there in turn number four as they are working on that 88H car and they're checking things out as we are under the red flag. And we've got ourselves a complete restart here once we get back going again here. But obviously thinking of everybody over there down in turn number four as Hargrove, that was a tough lick.
Well, Jake, I gave him a lot of credit making it through turn one and two clean. And then, you know, sometimes you get that confidence on the start going through one and two. You think, okay, pedal a little harder in three and four. And then, boom, it all came unglued. Tough break there. Hate to see that on lap one. Such a great field. And, you know, luckily, I think it only got three, maybe four cars. Got a couple of them down in the grass. Nobody over the pit wall, please. Nobody over the wall on the racetrack. Everybody needs to stay in the pit area or else you will be disqualified. Again, everybody needs to stay in the pit area or you will be disqualified. Thank you.
Not the way you want to start this night, but they are working down there in turn number four. We should be, as you mentioned prior to coming up here, we should be having our 50-50 winner being announced here soon. So if you've got a 50-50 ticket, I want to hang tight as we're going to be announcing that winner coming up in just a bit. So we appreciate everybody hanging out. And this Clyde Hart Memorial this weekend kicking off what's going to be a great weekend of racing over here on the East Coast of Florida as tomorrow night. The Xfinity Series takes to the high banks of Daytona International Speedway, followed by the final race of the regular season coming up Saturday night under the lights of Daytona International Speedway. We'll see what 16 drivers are going to compete for the NASCAR Cup Series Championship going forward. And all this racing action starting here tonight, and we still got plenty of racing to do here. So if you've got an opportunity here, if you're still hungry, you're still thirsty, head on down to the concession stand, get yourself something to eat, go get yourself a nice cold beverage, especially if you're not working tomorrow.
I know a lot of people have work tomorrow, have young kids that need to get home, and we're not trying to keep you here. We hope you'll stay. Enjoy the rest of the night with the Bombers and the Ground Pounders still to come. As soon as we get that 50-50 raffle ticket, the raffle bag up here, we'll draw the ticket just as soon as we can for you. We don't want you to leave here empty-handed so we can take home a nice chunk of money. They are working on that for us, so we will get that away just as soon as we have an opportunity. And there you see what's left of the 88 for Justin Hargrove. Tough luck there for the Dale Jr. lookalike.
I would say that ABM machine has seen better days as the right front of that car is caked in pretty significantly there as they make the left-handed turn back behind pit wall. As they're still working to fix things up over there in turn number four, looked like a lot of fluid put down on the track. And a tough break there for the 87, as you mentioned, first time out. Hopefully a smoother start here, but the players up here to put the wheel on that outside line. As we get ready to turn two,
Thank you. Brady X. A great run going for her. Hopefully they can get her back out and try to continue for this race. If she goes good, we can get some more spots.
Yeah, right as we were getting ready to take the green there, the X car of Breeden slowed down back straight away. Came to a stop, and luckily our track officials were able to see it before they waved the green flag. But the drivers, they were primed and ready to go there. Turn three, four, but everybody stopped. They slowed back up again. They did not have any incidents as they headed down into turn number one that time under the caution. Still just 23 laps complete, 40 laps lead the distance. As you see, one of the ground pounders, or rather a couple of ground pounders, have made their way out onto the pit road. That's the sweet heart. We got that 50-50 winner coming up here in just a little bit. We'll let you know what the total for that's going to be here in a few minutes. And like Ryan said, it took him a long time to count the money, so that's usually a pretty good sign. Okay, so $200 tonight with our 50-50. So if we get another caution here, we will draw the winning ticket then. If not, if we go green the rest of the way, we'll pull the winning ticket down in the victory lane. So the lights are out of the pace car, speeding up down the backstretch, and we'll make the hard left here down the pit lane as we're ready to go back to green. Great battle up front. after he stalled it coming down through turns 3 and 4. And that's going to be the number 21 of Todd Latour. And we were talking about how this was going to affect the point standings. And this is definitely going to make things tight as the 47 are right, who has to drop back to the back now. He came in only 1 point out of the lead, or rather, Wright had the lead by 1 point. Now Todd Latour, he's going to restart up in the second spot. And Dan Webb, we just mentioned, he had trouble as well. So Latour with a chance to.
Driving your own race. We'll see how that all calculates.
Lots to calculate here tonight.